Fueled by Deathcast.
What are the crowds like for Exodus in Europe? Is it bigger? Is it always a bigger thing?
I don't know if it's bigger. I guess yes and no. I think more loyal, if that makes any sense
totally.
To you at all. They love it to death. You know, they're still into the battle jackets with the patches on it. I mean, that is still huge. I only remember that in the 80s here.
Yeah.
You know, that died out. But they're very much into that total, you know, if they love you, there's people that follow us around. Their vacation's coming up, and they're going to go spend 8 days with Exodus. And so it's just a different mentality, I think. But the European crowd's definitely, South America's too, the same way, Japan. Yeah. It's like America's got a lot of things going on, so there's a lot of distractions. So, and metal gets no love, really, in the United States. There's not a television show or really a national radio show that has any, you know, Eddie Trunk does his thing, and
yep.
Liquid Metal, but there's no TV show. They had that metal show for a few years. They don't do that. So there's nothing. If you watch the award shows on television, there's not even one hard rock award anymore. Yep. So it's not really catered to us. So I think if you love it, you totally love it. And that's great because it's fans forever. I mean, how many bands that put a record out from other genres of music in 1985 can still put out new records and people go, wow, that's fresh. That's still great. It's still heavy. It's still got some edge to it, you know?
And it is a shame that we live in that world where, you know, not just metal, but I feel like rock as a whole is just...
Oh, I agree. Oh, I so agree. It's just awful. I mean, Huda was that at halftime at the football game the other day, and Gary Holt made a big statement on Facebook about it. I can't even remember because they're not even a rock. I don't care. How can you call that rock? Do you call Coldplay rock?
No.
Do you call Maroon 5 rock?
No.
Because that's what they're dishing out as rock. The only one I can give any respect to are Foo Fighters.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They're rock still. But there's, I mean, I grew up, you know, I'm 50, maybe 55 years old. I grew up in the 70s when all there was Rod Stewart and Fleetwood Mac and the Eagles and Led Zeppelin and the Rolling Stones. It was rock, you know?
Yeah.
You know, and of course you had Earth, Wind, and Fire and great soul bands and R&B bands, but it wasn't like, you know, just the pop music today is just awful. Yeah. I mean, I could deal with the Osmond Brothers. I could deal with, you know, the Jackson 5. I could deal with that, the DeFranco family. You know, I can't deal with this stuff. I just won't listen to it.
Yeah.
What do you think makes it so deplorable?
I don't think there's much musicianship in it anymore.
Yeah.
I think every they go into a room with buttons and just put it so there's nothing coming from the heart. They're gonna get popular. They're gonna go into the studio. Like I see this all the time. Guys are writing lyrics in the studio and then they're splurting it out. It's like, you know, it's like, did you have time to think about really, is that really good enough? You know, are you composing a song and that's it? You know what I mean? And so I just think it's kind of, well, that's why it's kind of waste paper basket. You don't see anybody buying catalog of rap records, even from 3 years ago, but they're still buying Bonded by Blood. You know what I mean? So
totally.
It's a different demographic when it comes to that.